So the previous rule of foul and a miss, which was omitted from the rules format, has been reinstated. So once again, just to get this underway, we are about to start the final match of the 2012 United States Snooker National Championships. Streaming live. From the beautiful Embassy Club in San Gabriel, California. On these beautiful Riley's tables. 12 tables in all here at the Embassy Club. So for anybody who enjoys snooker, I highly recommend you come on down to the Embassy Club to play snooker. You could not find a nicer venue. This is the largest snooker venue in the United States. We just have some notable figures on the board of the USSA and owners of the Billiard Club. Paul Yu, Tom Collins, Ajeya Prabhakar, Don Sitarski, the tournament director, Hugh Brown, are all just taking some pictures and getting... the formalities taken care of here. Before we start this final match here between Ajeya Prabhakar and Sargon Isaac, best of 9 frames. All right, Tom Collins, like I said earlier, is going to be the referee for this match, and he's putting on the white gloves. And Tom Collins.
Tom on the scoring this afternoon, we have Don Sitarski.
Our referee, and Don Sitarski will be scoring.
And to player number one, originally from Nottingham in England, that tells me he's left his bow and arrow behind, could I ask you please to welcome Sargon Isaac. Sargon's opponent this afternoon is in fact the president of the United States Snooker Association, Ajeya Prabhakar.
All right, our players have shook hands there, and there's the flip.
I'll break.
And Sargon wins the flip, and he is going to break.
Sargon Isaac.
And here we go, folks. The final match between Ajeya Prabhakar and Sargon Isaac, who will be breaking. Best of 9 frames. First 1 to 5 frames will be the winner of the United States National Championships here for 2012. Off. It's good speed. It's a very good break, but Sargon has left 1 red available. Oh, and a bad miss because he's left red open. And Sargon's going to take this red in the middle pocket. He's a little bit hampered, so he's grabbing the rest. Assistance with the rest there. Tom is also an international class 3 referee. Going to have to force the cue ball with some pace. Over to the side cushion there. He might actually stun back for that open red by the black. No, he's not going to do that. Oh, there's a... I failed to see that red towards the top right pocket. Take the difficult cut on the blue. Great shot. He played with enough
18.
speed to get nice on this red. And once he makes that red, he'll open up the other red at the bottom of the pack.
Sargon Isaac, 18.
And that's a break of 18 for Sargon. Lunging out of the gate. Jay has been playing on the table next to him for a considerable period, so it's going to take him a minute to get used to the speed of this table. He left an open red for Sargon, but fortunately for Ajeya, it doesn't go in. And an unforced error by Sargon. He leaves this red available. Ajeya.
Oh. Sargon Isaac, 4.
Another 4 points for Sargon. That red beautifully. Sargon.
Ajeya Prabhakar, 8.
Sargon has a choice to play this long red. He's going to take it on. He played it at such a pace so as to leave a difficult shot to the middle pocket. I don't know if he actually went for that bet. afraid to take these shots on. And, the success on the long shots seems to be pretty good too. Shot on the black. And has he opened something up for himself? It looks like he's got that bottom red.
Eight.
He wants to shoot at this blue. Probably, it looks like he's putting a draw on it. Played to Canna. Oops, sorry about that, folks. Their home room is Shoreline Billiards. And Sargon, who was commentating with me earlier, told us that they play together quite a lot at Shoreline. Good speed.
Thank you.
obviously struggling a little bit this frame. Whether it be with the speed of the table or maybe just his familiarity with Sargon's game.
Yellow.
Oh, dangerously close to fouling there. Side middle pocket three. Scratch.
Yeah,
I didn't want to miss that.
43 plays 13.
Yeah.
left on the table. So Sargon's not in the safe zone yet for this first frame. By Ajeya, not good enough to overtake Sargon, who leads by 13 points. In this first frame here. like very quickly. Ajeya is becoming comfortable.
Ajeya Prabhakar, score please.
43 plays 38.
Actually, Well, Sargon needs through the green before Ajeya starts acquiring snookers.
Recognizing seven.
Chance here. Look at this. Look at this cue ball. I think Sargon can see a piece of the yellow, but he might just kick. No, he can see more of it than I thought. Now this is going to be a good safety. Good speed, good speed. Folks, Sargon needs up to the brown here before Ajeya starts requiring snookers.
Ball on the miss, Sargon Isaac, four.
And foul and a miss. Sargon asked to have the ball put back. As I said, he needs to the brown. He's basically only needs to the green. Point difference here. Shot to nothing here from Sargon.
38 by 62. Two.
green's going. The green's going. It needs to go. It's not going to get there. Now is 25, and there are 24 points on the table. 22 points on the table. So Ajeya definitely needs a snooker now. These other balls need to get off the rail if Ajeya wants to have any chance of trapping Sargon into a snooker scenario. And that looks like what he's doing is he's aiming the brown ball at the black. But with great risk for obviously, it's very difficult to calculate where the object balls are going to go when you shoot at them like that. It's a good thing for him. He played the cue ball.
Four.
Well, Derby County commenting in the chat room that Ajeya should concede, but after that brown, I couldn't agree with you more. Twenty-nine points ahead now.
And the frame
to Sargon Isaac. So that'll be frame one in a best of nine. And we're gonna get started with frame two right away.